In the month of October, 1,378 motor accidents were registered in our country. And today we sit down with Assistant Superintendent of Police to tell us what is the cause, what is the problem, and what is the way forward. Now, Farida, you have been quoted saying that motorcycles are a menace on the road, and that in every 5 motor accidents, then 4 of them are of motorcycles. What is the problem? Don't these motorcyclists realize that they are at risk of actually losing their lives?
The problem causing the crashes on the road is the violation of the traffic rules and regulations on the road. If you don't follow the rules on the road, you crash. That's where the problem is. Most of them riding the motorcycles have not attained any basic knowledge on how to use the road. You find the person buys a motorcycle today, tomorrow he puts it on the road and he's riding it. So he doesn't know any basic on the road. He doesn't know any rule on the road. That means he will not respect the rules on the road and he will be hit or he will hit another person. It's the cause of the increase in the crashes in motorcycles. It's the industry that is bringing every day. New motorcycles are coming on the road, but have the riders learned how to use the road? No.
But officer, in a meeting between the Speaker of Parliament, Honorable Anita Among, and the Deputy Inspector General of Police, she ordered him to come up with solutions to curb these accidents. Are there any specific activities or solutions that you have come up with?
Okay, in traffic we have crashes, we don't have accidents.
Yes.
An accident is something you can't prevent, but what you watch out there happening is preventable. That means we come up with preventive measures on crashes, guiding, sensitizing, telling them riding in one way, you'll be hit. Not wearing your crash helmet in case of a crash, your skull will crack and you bleed and die. So we are coming up with preventive measures to prevent the crashes. Though you can't stop them, but you can prevent some of them from happening. That's if we protect their heads, the death number will reduce. If they wear the reflective jacket, they'll be seen from a distance. If they pick the basics that we teach them, the change out there will be seen. The behavior and the attitude out will improve. And that's what we are doing as traffic police.
Briefly tell us about this operation. What is it and how long is it going to be?
Remember, we do operations every day as Traffic Directorate. But during the festive season, we intensify our operations. That means the energy, the coverage, and the numbers go high. Why? It's because during the festive season, more people come on the road. More vehicles come on the road. That means more people use the road. Motorcycles have increased on the road. That means still we shall register more crashes because of the increase of the population on the road. So before the festive season, let's do some enforcement. Let's adjust to prepare for the big time coming up. So festive season runs from November to the end of January. That is the intensive. Then we go back to the normal that we've been doing before.
Farida, we live in a money economy whereby you need to have money to make ends meet or to live. Now, you have this person who comes from their village after selling their ancestral land, comes into the city, uses that money to buy a motorcycle, and is hoping to get into this business, break even, and improve their lives. What would you advise that person who is actually facing this risk of death?
I wish everyone who buys a motorcycle learns the basics before using the motorcycle on the road. It would be the best. Because if you have a basic knowledge on road safety, you never violate any traffic law on the road. It's them not knowing what to do on the road that is majorly causing the carnage on the road involving motorcycles. Because they will be looked at as people who violate all the laws on the road. It's because they don't know anything. My advice to you is, this is a job. this motorcycle you're buying, it has a law that manages it on the road. Have you learned something about the law that takes the motorcycle on the road? Do you have any knowledge on the road that you're going to use, trade your motorcycle? Because these motorcycles they buy and operate, they cater for the whole family. They pay school fees for their children. They feed people. They take responsibilities of taking people to hospitals. That means if that person dies, these children never go back to school. This family will not have what to eat. Even this is looked at by everyone in the community. You find one motorcycle, it's ridden by three people. That means it's employment. But shall we sustain the motorcycle on the road if we don't know the basics? As it's hit on the road, we are losing a life. Has the motorcycle remained? If it is gone, that means the whole thing is finished. So let's learn the basics first before we put the motorcycle on the road.
Now, thank you for watching us this week. I am Vivian Kamsime for the Motorcycle Riders and the Border Borders specifically. It is about your life. Take time to train, to understand the signages, and to know how to actually use the road.